Hi everyone, I'm Wilsonator, and welcome back to Satisfactory. That's right, we're here overlooking our factory, which we rebuilt pretty much last time. We did all of this stuff here. Look at this. This is crazy. I can't believe I built this. And we also built that. Yep, that's right. We've got a space elevator. We pretty much spent the last episode building this kind of conveyor system here. So just as a little recap, we are smelting a load of iron over here. We're bringing it over to make plates over here. We're making iron plates. And then we're also making a load of iron rods. I mean, like, fuck tons of iron rods. Some of these are just sat in the machines right now. And then the other iron rods we've got here are being split off to make screws. And then what we're doing with all of this stuff together is coming in to this assembler, and we're making reinforced iron plates. We have 35. 46 of them total now. Holy fuck. Now, bear in mind, these were really rare, like, earlier on. Like, I was really struggling with these because you had to make them by hand, and that was quite frustrating. But now we have, like, infinite, basically. So, yeah, we also got the molecular analysis machine last time, which we probably want to look into doing some stuff with today. There's a few things we're going to want to do today. We want to try and scan for slugs. We want to find these power slug things. Because you can make power shards, which can increase the efficiency of a machine, believe it or not. So there's also, we want to make, I believe when we were finishing up last time, let me just quickly check this again. We wanted to make smart plating. We need to make this to send it into the space elevator. So we're going to need to make rotors, and then I think it's just rotors and reinforced plating that does the job. So let's get started here by just expanding our foundations out a little bit further. I don't know if this is going to permanently be where we create these plates, but this is where we're doing it for now. And so people were telling me that I should probably build stuff up on top of other stuff, and I can do that. You're correct. We can build, like, a second floor. Do they need, like, stability, or can you just build them, I wonder? Do we want to do that, though? We don't even have any lights or anything yet. Like, I don't know, dude. I don't really want to do it. Can this float, I wonder? Yes, it can just float. I don't know, man. We'll probably build, like, a proper building stuff at some point. I just don't like it. I actually kind of like the, I like the sunlight hitting my factory. I don't know. We'll probably build some sort of building at some point. We want assembler there. And rotors. It only needs 20 per minute, 100 per minute. 100 screws per minute. Where's this one getting again? 60 and 30. So, 20 rods and 100 screws. Okay, let's try and do that. Okay, I need to try and remember this. My brain has kind of switched off on this this kind of stuff right now. So this puts out 40 screws per minute. So these give us 40 screws each. Why don't we get 100 first for the for that one? That makes it easier, right? So we'll just simply split 20 off of here, and then we'll have 100 screws ready to go. Let's merge those, and then we're going to merge the split output from here, right? Okay, so this should give us a total of 100 per minute, right? So we've got 40, 80, and then 100 total, right? And then this will go straight into, like, this one, I guess. So then we need 20 iron rods. So good thing is we've got iron rods right here, and they produce 15 per minute. How do you get 20 from 15? I'm kind of dumb. We can merge them into 30 and then split them three ways and then merge two of the 10 outputs. God, this is getting confusing. Do you know what? It's funny. Everyone's like, maths with basic maths with Wilson. This is really confusing to me, right? I'm not very good at maths, clearly. Can we just directly into there? Yep. So that's 30 rods total. So this gives us 30 split into three ways, and then we want to merge two of them to make 20, right? It's going to be a bit messy looking, I guess, but it's fine. Okay. We're going to have to go this up and then down. Just like that. Should be fine. and then go straight into there. So we should start being able to get some rotors now. Look, yep, there we go. We're producing rotors. All right, thank fuck. It doesn't look too bad actually. It just comes up and then down. So now we need to get 60 screws into this one. So how are we gonna do that? Let's take a little look. Okay, we can just combine this output and then 20 from here to make 60. That would do the job, right? So this should give us 60. Okay, this is gonna start getting a little bit wacky looking, but we're gonna start going up here. Look at this, right? It comes over here. I like the conveyor poles because they give you more direct control over where the conveyor will go. Like that. Okay. This should work, right? So, comes over here. Alright, so it looks pretty wacky, but we should be merging. So, this should be 20 coming out here, merged with 40 from here, which gives us 60. Comes along here, and again, the 60 is what this machine here wants. It wants 60, so we're producing this at 100% efficiency. 100% efficiency on this too. All right, brilliant. Whew. Okay, that was a lot more complicated than I expected it to be. Just getting rotors being crafted. Look at this, though. We've started doing some verticality. See, I'm rather than making a second floor, like right off the bat, I want to make things vertical like this, like having conveyors going over each other and stuff. That looks so cool. It looks awesome, dude. It looks like really complicated and stuff. It's just, it's funny to think a dumbass like me could make something like this. So smart plating is one reinforced plate and one rotor. That's actually easy. That's an easy output. It does want 2 per minute. Oh wait, we need to watch our ratios here. Actually, this makes 4 per minute. This makes 5 per minute. So it is quite a slow craft. So we could just bring the output of that smart plating. We could just take it straight to the elevator. We should just do that and then we can leave it running and it will fill up the elevator by itself. Okay, there we go. We got a line. Look at this. So our first smart plating is making its way to the space elevator. So do we send it all up as one or can we send it up a bit at a time? Man, smart plating looks pretty cool. It looks really smart looking. Look at it. So I just want to take a look at this. Like once it gets into the space elevator, how do we, like what do we do with it next? I can't seal it. I guess it has to be filled. Okay, cool. So you can't send it up until it's filled. Right, that makes sense. All right, so what is the next step here? We could make some of this stuff. Awesome sink. Turn straight useful parts straight into research data. Logistics 2 is a good idea too. So I believe someone actually told me this. I think 100 items per second. So with the outputs, like for example on this, right, where it produces 60 per minute, if it gets to up to 100, that 100 is the limit of these Mark 1 conveyor belts. So once you get to like outputs that are higher than that, you're gonna need like faster conveyor belts essentially if you want to keep up like efficiency. So we'll get the molecular analysis machine thingy down again, and I would like to try and do some of that while we're sort of waiting for this to produce enough. Obviously if we wanted to, we can make like a second production line for smart plating it, like if we wanted to speed it up, but I think for now it's fine. I mean, it is, look, it's slowly doing it. Start research. There we go. Tell me how to scan a slug. I wanna find them. I wanna find all the slugs. Also, what about jump pads? I'd like to maybe look into that, because that could be good if we can get around our base faster. 50 rotors, 300 plates. It's not actually that hard to make. We just need to get those rotors. Let's go. Jump pads have been unlocked. Where did they go? Transportation. Jump pad. Propels you upwards through the air. Make sure you land softly. Tilted jump pad. Make sure you land softly. And U-Jelly. It uses biomass. So we also unlocked for the object scanner. We can look. We've got power slugs unlocked. It's beeping. That's one up there. That's also one up there, I'm pretty sure. Let's just check how this works. So it beeps as we get close to the slugs. Oh my fuck. Yoink. Oh shit, I need to kill this guy first. Wait. Come on, bitch. You wanna go? Huh? Yeah, that's what I thought. Get fucked, you alien fuck. Alright, we're collecting a slug. There we go. I see a few of them. Look, there's another one all the way over there. And there's also one over there. Man, look at this world, man. We need to go exploring soon. I want to get a better form of transport, though. I don't want to run all the way on foot. Buildings can now be overclocked with the use of power shards, it says. Ah, here we go. Look. We could pop that in there, right? And clock up to... Target production rate, 3 per minute. It still says 2 plates per minute, though, that it needs. Does it bump up the power rating or no? That's kind of awesome that you can do that. It doesn't seem to use more power either, weirdly enough. Oh, it has bumped up the rotors, so look. I'm sure that was 2 per minute before. Yeah, yeah, see, updated now. Does it update the power usage as well? This is 50 megawatts. Oh, it has bumped up by quite a lot, nearly by double, look, 28 megawatts. The power usage goes up more. We're at 150% clock speed, but we've nearly doubled power consumption. Right, tilted jump pad. I'm trying. Okay, right. That works. I mean, boink. Ah! I mean, wow, that's a lot bigger than I expected. Does this need power too? It does. Oh, wow. Look at this. Oh. Oh, shit. But I'm gonna drown. I'm stuck in here. Oh, you can just walk out of it. Okay. Whew. I don't know how useful this is to me. Just to get from here to there. I mean... It works, but I feel like we could just quickly run that distance. I mean, look, it's not that far. When I say that, it's actually... I mean, it's faster. We might use it. We could research those. Alien carapace research. That's a very quick one. Done. Biomass from alien. Look. We can get biomass from an alien. Also, alien organs. Let's research those. The analysis of alien organs is completed. Please choose a new node. Biomass from alien organs. We can research that right now. Look. Organic properties. So what did that do? Did that give us the ability to craft biomass from aliens? Yep. Oh, that's a lot too. 200 from one organ. Dude, we need to go hunt some aliens. The amount of biomass that we can get from them is kind of ridiculous. We need, I think, 10. I think it's 10 alien carapace. We can research biomass from that. Alien organs. I don't know what we get those from. Oh, we got it. Seal. Oh, boys. It's look, the package. Are you ready? Is he going to send it up? Oh, my God. Look. Oh, my God. Oh, look at it go. Oh, dude, that's so cool. Man, I'm never going to get enough of these animations. Holy fuck. It's off to space. Look. Did we unlock the next tier then? Because this is the next part. Look, what's this? Versatile framework. Automated wiring. 500 smart plane we need for the next one. Fuck me, that's crazy. Okay. Wow. All right, let's check the hub. I want to take a look and see what we unlocked. Because I think we've unlocked the next tiers. Yeah, we've got tier 3 and 4. Coal power. Ooh. Ooh, nice. Coal power. Vehicle transport. Tractor. Truck station. Basic steel production. And tier 4. Improved melee combat. Xeno basher. Advanced steel production. Hypertubes. And logistics mark 3. I kind of would love to get coal power. Coal generator. Where do we get coal, though? Whoa. Oh, we're out of power. Luckily, we have some biofuel. Kind of, I would like coal power, but I don't know where to find it. I'm assuming we'll be able to scan for it once we unlock that tier, right? 25 slot inventory has a built-in craft bench, can be automated to pick up and deliver resources at truck stations. I kind of would like to get this. I wanna get this. I wanna be able to go in a vehicle, but at the same time, you know what I think we need to do first of all? We need to stop producing smart playing for the time being. I don't think it would need it right now. We need 500 for the next space elevator point. So I'm just going to stop transport, or I'm going to stop turning it into smart plating. We're going to produce it, and that'll be it, right? Because we need these rotors at the moment for other stuff, I think. I think we probably want transport, though, so we can actually explore to find it. I think this would be the best thing for us right now. So let's get some of this stuff in here. As much as we can, we'll go get the rest of it. So what we're going to do, while we wait for these rotors, because it's going to take us a little bit of time, we're going to go and try and find a couple of aliens to kill. We're going to go on a little hunt. Yeah, we're going to try and kill them and get some alien organs. And then we'll be able to make loads of biomass, and that should help us with power. Should we just try and kill one of these elephants? I feel really bad about it, because they're so peaceful. But they probably give us a load of organs. Fuck, alright. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry, okay? Run the fucking butt. Oh, look at him go. Wow, I never thought he could run so fast. Can he fight back? He seems to be stuck. I'll help you out. Look, oh, he's stuck on a rock. Oh, you poor son of a... Oh, no, he's going. He got free. Whoa. Oh, shit. It's one of these. Oh, shit. Oh, these ones are the, these ones shoot fireballs. We have to be a little bit careful here. We're actually not... We don't have too much health. Ow. Wait, give me some fucking berries. All right. And some nuts. Give me some of them nuts. Not those kind of nuts, you dirty bastards. Fuck, it's hard to get them. We need a ranged weapon, man. These guys are really fucking... Wait, two of them as well. I mean, thankfully, they're sort of stuck on this tree. So we can retreat. Okay, one's dead. Both dead. There we go. Whew, fuck. Never expected such a crazy fight. What is that? Hey, man. Seems friendly. What is that? It's alive! It's alive! What is it? I don't know. I don't like the look of it, though. We need 10 carapaces, so let's just hunt a few more of these guys. Come on, you bitch. That's right. Jumped over you. What are you gonna do about it? We need to get a ranged weapon. We need, like, a gun or something. Alright, there we go. I know you're scared after I killed all of your brethren, but... you, unfortunately, do have to die, too. I need one more carapace, so... Come on, bitch. Right in the butt. Right, easy. He's so fast. Look at him go. Oh my god. Oh shit, I'm trying to fight the big boy, not you. Fuck, he's really fast. It might be hard to kill him when he's running around like this. Oh man, I feel so bad about... Oh, he just despawned. Oh man, what? Okay, that's a bug. Also, I'm stuck. Fuck, I'm stuck. I'm fully stuck. I can't move. Ah! I don't know what I did. Oh, you know what I did? I pressed C, the crouch button. I was pressing control, thinking that was the crouch button. C was the crouch button. What is that? I'm guessing... Ah! 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 Oh, no, there's cats! There's fucking spiders! Oh, fuck! Boys! 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 What have we done? Slug! No, I don't want it! Help! There's a spider! I'm not ready to fight them yet, man. I'm not ready. They're too fast. I know that they look like cats, but I'm still fucking scared of them, man. The sounds they make. Like, ugh. Look at this. I guess we're at the edge of the world here. I reckon we can conveyor belt our way up. Look. Okay. It's all going so nice and smooth, and now... We're trapped on the side of a cliff at the edge of the world. Okay, we good? Kinda. No, you bitch, I can hear them. They're gonna charge me off. Wait, I need my stuff! Oh! See you later, bitch! You wanna go too? Huh? That's right, bitch. Have a nice trip. Well, things got intense very fast out here. Holy shit. Okay, we're not quite ready to explore beyond home, apparently. There's a lot of crazy shit. This wasn't even that far. Although, it looks like we found the edge on this side. I'm guessing it's all that way is the way we can explore. We're probably at the southern border of the map here, though. Oh, there we go. We've got enough rotors now that we can actually do this. Whoa, what's this? A rebar gun and spiked rebars. Okay, that's something we'll probably want to get soon. Boom. Vehicle transport is off and away. Look at it. Oh my god. That is incredible. What type of fuel does it take? Biofuel? Oh, it does. Wait. Oh! Boys! Look at this! We're driving a truck! I can't believe it. You can record a vehicle path. Autopilot active, no. Oh my god. This is incredible. It actually controls pretty well. Right. We have no ramp here, so. Right. Cool. Cool. I think we're going to finish this episode here. We've done quite a lot of interesting things today. I mean, not so much actual work on the factory other than that little area over there that we did at the start of the episode. A thing for rotors and then for smart plating. We obviously hooked that up to the space elevator and we shipped off loads of smart plating up into space. And then we went exploring. Came across a bunch of weird shit. And also nearly died on a cliff at the edge of the map. We've also done some researching today. We researched those slugs and we've managed to get some power shards. We actually have 3 of them. So yeah, we're going to finish here. I hope you guys have enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching and I will see you next time.